Good afternoon, everyone. Today's committee on cities one. I believe this is our second to last.
Probably have one more.
One more meeting, this is our second to last. We have a relatively short agenda, so we'll move on quickly.
First bill is Senate 1378 by Senator Felder for first report with amending administrative code of the City of New York in relation to prohibiting certain surcharges on credit card or debt card transactions to prevent a surcharge from being imposed when using a credit card or debit card to pay a fine, penalty, or fee.
Would you like to elaborate at all, Senator, why you brought the bill?
I don't want to talk because I think people will be more inclined to vote if I shut my mouth.
So first, let me move the bill, if you don't mind.
Yes.
Second.
Can I comment, sir, if you don't mind?
Of course.
This is 2023.
Yes.
In fact, I don't even, like, right now, the only thing I'm carrying is my credit card and debit card. This is not 1950 or 19, not even 2 years ago. People are moving towards credit cards and automatic paying from their account. So this is a good thing.
All right, so the bill has been moved. Any other discussion? Okay, there's a motion by Senator Jackson, seconded by Senator Prasad.
Giving up plenty of those to the
All right, so the bill passes.
First report.
Thank you.
Second bill.
Second bill is Senate 3252 by Senator Loop, also for first report, would amend the real property tax law in relation to extending certain provisions relating to a partial tax abatement for residential real property held in cooperative or condominium form of ownership in the City of New York. It would extend for 2 years this abatement.
Good bill.
Any discussion?
Good bill. Move to bill.
Moved by Senator Comrie.
Second.
Second by Senator Jackson. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Any against?
No.
Everybody likes this bill. All right, next one. This bill, if passed, will be referred to housing.
Senator Jackson's bill, Senate Bill 4960, would require all affordable housing programs in the City of New York to calculate the area median income based on the zip code in which the project would be located. The purpose of the legislation is to advance affordable housing in New York City by requiring the use of a particular zip code in the AMI.
So let me just comment on this. This is my bill. If you look at it, the AMI in the federal government right now in New York City, Long Island and Westchester County, and does not really reflect the realities in our community. So for example, I represent Washington Heights and Inwood and parts of the Northwest Bronx where the average family earns less than $70,000 a year, less than that. And so this is important for the people that are struggling to work and do the best they can to support their families and to be able to have housing. So that's why this bill is important.
Any other discussion?
No, I think it's a good bill. Move the bill.
All I can say is that had he not put this bill forth, I would have done it because
right.
Clearly, I mean, I had the poorest district, as you know.
Clearly,
this would be a lifesaver for affordable housing. All right. Motion.
I'll move the bill. I just want to also comment. I thought that this bill had been proposed before. I was told it couldn't be done, but I'm glad that you're doing
it. Oh, yes.
Yep.
We'll make every effort to localize it. I know that we were able to do spot AMIs on certain projects.
Mm-hmm.
When we were in the city council, Robert Jackson and myself, so I don't understand why we can't make sure we do spot AMIs on projects now. So I'm happy that this bill is in. I wish it were me proposing it.
Yeah, but we were told that you couldn't do it.
We were
told you couldn't do it.
Well, we reported last year, so
Well, we'll find out who's trying to stop it from getting to the floor.
Yeah, we'll work from up somewhere. Motion to move the bill. Motion by Senator Clear, seconded by Senator Comrie.
Senator Lanza is without recommendation.
All in favor?
Aye.
All against? Okay, one without rec. The bill is referred to housing. And last but not least.
Will it land with AWR?
Yes.
Okay, thank you.
Yes.
Last bill, Senate 6225 by Senator Felder, would authorize the City of New York to reduce the interest accrued on certain charges assessed on real property located at 1690 60th Street in Brooklyn. It would rectify a bureaucratic process which the City of New York is unable to amend accrued interest. And there's about a you know, this was an original charge of $34,000, which with accrued interest and penalties has now grown to $1.3 million.
Ouch. Ouch.
Is this a, may I ask you a question, Senator?
Yes.
Is this a good church building or something that was purchased and...
The property was an old age home.
Mm-hmm.
It was sold to a rabbinical college, and in the transition, there was a violation for rats, other things. It wasn't being taken care of.
Right.
I don't know whose fault it is, but the old story, the issue of the interest, Senator Jackson and I, you know, were in the council at the same time. It's an old story. At some point in time, New York City eliminated the issues of penalty, and they got rid of it. It's only interest, and the interest rate, I don't know now, is something like 19-something percent usurious. And the reason that was done is because under the law, the commissioner is permitted to forgive penalties. The commissioner cannot forgive interest. So they decided no more penalties. There's no such thing as penalties, only interest. So on a property like this, which they were fighting around with, that's how they get one point something million, because there's interest, and the commissioner couldn't do anything about it, and that's where it is.
Okay. Motion to move the bill?
Move the bill.
Second. Motion by Senator Jackson, second by Senator Connery. All those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed?
No.
Okay, well, the ayes have it. Everyone have a great day.
Thank